So the US just withdrew from the Iran deal, and the geopolitical equivalent of inviting your friend to a party, having him ask if he can bring his friend to a party, and then that friend of a friend bailing at the last second. Sure, it's kind of annoying, but we're not canceling the entire thing just because that guy bailed. So what did happen? Because the nuclear agreement is still in place, just without us. And the sanctions from countries that have actually done trade with Iran since the period when it was still a draw to have Chuck Norris in your movie are still flowing free. Well, first, the US has imposed sanctions on Iran, so we won't export or import anything from them, which, interestingly enough, might hurt us more, as in the past few years, we've had a very strong trade surplus with Iran. But I've known Trump not to be motivated by things like trade surpluses. Don't get me wrong, we haven't done much trade with Iran overall, and the one thing we really brought to the table in these negotiations were the billions in frozen Iranian assets that were thawed. Although, because of this, I'm sure Hassan Rouhani isn't exactly jumping in excitement to open up a new Wells Fargo account, despite the fact that the US government could really use the leverage. The other big asset we brought to the table was strong-arming our allies, who actually traded with Iran, to the table, which, seeing as they're not the type to renege on deals, are leaving it pretty much as it currently is, except without us. So yeah, pretty much nothing changed. All the restrictions remained in place, all the inspections are still happening, and the trade is still happening between Iran and countries relevant to Iranian trade. All that's really happened was the US gave up trade to one of the few countries we actually have a slight trade surplus to, and might have slightly sullied our reputation as people who back out of deals, with the president of Turkey and man who is really trying to convince us he can grow a mustache, Erdogan, saying, "This is not how the international mechanisms work," he said. "International covenants and international conventions cannot be annulled upon will. If any document is bearing your signature, you need to respect that. You need to abide by that." Oh, stop it! You respect treaties as much as you respect the free press. But hey, for what it's worth, Israel is happy about all this, and that definitely seems to matter to a lot of voters. Anyways, for now, that's all I have to say about that. But I will be releasing the coverage of this news from both Fox and NBC in the coming days to see how both sides respond to this. So remember to subscribe and like so you can see what both parties are saying.